वेलकम एवरीवन, एम आई ऑडिबल?
Yes, sir, you are audible,
Yes,
please.
sir, you are audible. Yes.
Yeah, we'll start in another 2 minutes. I think people are joining. Another 1 or 2 minutes. Yeah, welcome to all the participants for the 17th session. 1 second. ಚಿಕ್ಕಪ್ಪ, ನಾನು ಮತ್ತೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ. ಹಲೋ, ನಾನು ಮತ್ತೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ. ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಟು ದ 17. ಚಿಕ್ಕಪ್ಪ, ನಾನು ಮತ್ತೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ. I'm getting continuous phone calls in the WhatsApp. Yeah. Prashant, shall we start now? Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Ready?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Welcome yes, to the 17th session of Arachnology. Here, I welcome Mr. Sankara Raman H from behalf of all the participants on behalf of Team Saliga. It's a great to have him here in our forum, and he is a PhD scholar from Annamalai University, and he has done his BSc in agriculture and MSc in agriculture entomology. Right now he is doing his PhD in entomology, and his research field is on taxonomy of Mimar.
Hello.
Parasitoids from. He's very humble and almost like an encyclopedia, I can say. Whatever you name it, he have it like that. So beautifully he presents, and all the ID he gives without any hesitation, and very friendly guy, and who is right here. And over to you, Sankar Raman. Thank you.
A very good evening to one and all present here. Hope all of you are safe and doing well. And Ajit sir has already given a brief introduction about me, and he has a lot of exaggeration given to me. It's not like that. Always happy to share whatever knowledge I have. That's it. And I hope we can enter into the topic. My topic is on insect predators and the webinar is on insect predators and parasitoids of spiders. And following are the topics to be discussed. The introduction, where I will be just briefing how many species, that is diversity of the spiders in the world, and how many spiders or species are known from India. And then we'll be discussing about the classification of natural enemies of the spiders, which includes both predators and parasitoids of the spiders. And what are all the major predators of the spiders? And following are the orders where we can find major predators of the spiders, that is order Hymenoptera, which includes bees, wasps, and of course the other entire groups of parasitoids, and then the Hemiptera, and then the order Neuroptera, which are also completely predatory. They are also predatory, completely predatory. And then major parasitoids of spiders is in the order of Hymenoptera and then Diptera. And finally, I'll be discussing about the exceptional cases in these groups. And giving about the introduction of why spiders are so important in nature. And spiders are important predators in agriculture and horticulture ecosystem, where they are acting as a biocontrol agent. So the consumption of pesticides can be reduced for managing the pest population. We might be knowing how much amount of pesticides are being sprayed to kill the insects in our field, and spiders are potential predators of these group of insects which are affecting the crops. They belong to the phylum Arthropoda, class Arachnida. The diversity of spiders is globally, there are 48,700 species known in 128 families, and in India only 1,690 species and 60 families are known. And this is 2008 census. That is the checklist was prepared by Manju Sullivan and her co-workers in 2008. And with active researchers in this field, every year at least 25 to 30 species, new species of spiders being described, and also with the help of course, citizen scientists like Abhijit sir. And classification of natural enemies. When do we call a natural enemy as a predator or a parasitoid, or in case parasite? A predator has to devour the prey, that is, consumes rapidly once they capture its prey, and it has to consume more than one host. That is, if there are large number of population of the pest species, the predator has to consume more than two or three organisms in the same habitat, and then it will be having some adaptive organs. For example, in case of a praying mantis or in case of a redivivid, the forelegs are modified into raptorial legs, which are allowing them to capture their prey. And when we call a natural enemy as a parasitoid, it has to develop on a single host. It can either develop externally or internally, what we call as an ecto or endoparasitoids. I'll be discussing it later in this webinar. And the parasite, what's the difference between a parasite and parasitoid is, parasitoid is actually called as a Proteulean parasite, which actually, the parasitoid actually kills the host in the process of development. But the parasite never kills the host, but derives the nutrients from the live host. That is, it never kills the host. For example, if you take a head louse, which is present on your head, it is just a parasite. It's obtaining nutrition from you, but it's not going to kill you. And same in case of the natural enemy, what we name it as parasite is, for example, a mantis pit fly grub, which belongs to Mantispidae. It derives nutrition from the egg of a spider, but never kills embryo developing within the spider. And that's why it is named as a parasite. And stages of spiders being attacked are, almost all the stages are being attacked by the natural enemies, egg, juveniles and adults. And of course, we know spiders and all do not have any pupa. They are not actually insects. They are, belong to a different class called Arachnida. And egg, juveniles and adults, all the stages of the spiders are being attacked by these natural enemies. Spiders being a potential predator in nature, what are the strategies the parasitoids or a predator in general, a natural enemy uses to attack a juvenile or an adult is exceptional. In case of eggs, it is an immobile stage and it is a completely vulnerable stage. It is attacked by the flies, that is true flies, dipterans and hymenopteran parasitoid complex, and also parasites such as mantis pit flies in Neuroptera, and also some of the hemipteran predators like Redivivida. And not all redwoods predate on these eggs. There is a particular subfamily called Amasinae, which are specialists on these group of spiders. And juveniles are being attacked by the dipteran and hymenopteran parasitoids. And adults are being attacked by hymenopteran predators and parasitoids, and as well as diptera also acting as a predator and parasitoids, and hemiptera being a predator of these spiders, all adult spiders. And classification of parasitoids is based on the stage. What is the stage being attacked by the parasitoid? That is egg parasitoid, which starts and completes its life cycle in the egg stage itself. Followed by Hymenoptera, and following are the families in Hymenoptera which are known to attack spiders. That is Ichneumonidae, Cilionidae, Pteromelids, and all are all known to attack spiders. And then in case of Diptera, that is true flies, Chloropidae, Ephedridae are known to attack. And there is another family called, in Diptera, there is another family called in adult parasitoids, ichneumonads and acroceridae, ichneumonidae is known to attack adult spiders, and acroceridae is exclusively, I'll tell you what exclusively means. And then chloropidae also known to attack adult spiders. And based on the feeding type, how we classify is ecto and endoparasitoids. And ectoparasitoids, it has to develop externally, derives nutrition from the host spiders, that is feeding on the hemolymph of the spider externally, and then kills the host, that is kills the spiders eventually in the process of development, and leave the host before pupation. And in case of endoparasitoids, the parasitoid develops internally, that is inside the abdomen of a spider. For example, acroceridae, which is developing within the abdomen of an adult spider or a juvenile spider. And in case of Cilionidae, we call endoparasitoids, they develop in the eggs of spiders, not in adults. Cilionidae are known to attack eggs alone, not the adult spiders. And acroceridae is known to attack adult and juvenile spiders. And based on the strategies in parasitism is idiobiont and coenobiont. What we call as idiobionts is the parasitoid inject a venom which prevents the host from further development, and there won't be no further development. So the the parasitoid completes its life cycle, and when it's parasitoid, it completes its life cycle as an egg itself. Inside the egg itself, it completes the life cycle. And in case of a coenobiont, it's the venom is temporary paralyzation of the host, where the egg, where the spider in the embryo spider developing within the egg can turn into a juvenile, and from the juvenile, the parasitoid can emerge out. And the host continues to, that's what the host continues to develop. In case of an egg, it can turn into a juvenile, and the parasitoid can emerge from out from a juvenile spider. Or in case of juveniles, that can turn into an adult, and from the adult spider, the parasitoid can emerge. And following groups are the major predators of spiders. The under order Hymenoptera, following families like Pompilidae, Speciidae, Crabronidae, and Ichneumonidae, they are exceptional cases where the grubs of larvae of Ichneumonidae acting as a predator of egg predators of spider egg sacs. I'll be dealing with those exceptional cases as I told earlier towards the end of this slide. And in case of Hemiptera reduvidae, that is particular subfamily called Emasinae, is known to be specialists on spiders. Not other reduvids, that is assassin bugs, attack spiders. And in case of Neuroptera, Mantispidae is known to, grubs of Mantispidae are known to parasitic on the, are known to be a parasite on eggs of spiders. And in case of Diptera, Bombylidae, that is bee flies, Drosophilidae, Aphidridae, and Sarcophagidae are all exceptional cases in, as egg predators. They're all acting as egg predators of spiders. And starting with the predators, the very known example is Pompilidae, where the adults are solitary and they construct their own nests, and prey on the adults and juvenile spiders. They are idiobionts, that is no development of the spider occurs, and it injects the venom, which it injects the venom where the spider do not develop further, and it has the Pompilidae wasp takes away the spider to its nest, where they lay their eggs on the spiders, and the wasp larva starts to develop on the spider by consuming the spider. Some of the groups, some of the Pompilids are also known to be kleptoparasitic, where they develop in the nests of other Pompilidae, and also they are ectoparasitoids of spiders, other spiders. And they attack spiders belonging to Lycosidae, Sparacidae, and Salticidae. And in case of other Hymenopteran predators, we must be familiar with Crabronidae. They do not construct their own nest. They occupy the nest of they occupy the nest of other hymenopterans, which has been abandoned. Crevices and walls are also being used as a nest, and broken plant stems, that is abandoned nests of bees and other wasps, are utilized for storing the collected spiders, and then the adult wasps lay their eggs on the spiders, and the larva of the wasp start developing on the spiders, and then the species A, what we call as thread-waisted wasp. Some of the examples are Charlie Beyond, Cleferon, the one with thin petiole, and has the, we must have seen mud dabbers, where they collect the sand, mud from the wet mud, and it constructs its own nest. And it has several chambers, as seen in the third image. You might be able to see there will be several spiders. They'll be paralyzed by the venom, which is being injected using the sting of the wasp. And then the paralyzed spider, the species A lay their eggs, and the larva of the species A starts developing on the spiders, and then eventually killing the spiders, consuming the internal content, and then pupates within the chamber, and the adults emerge out. And in case of Hemiptera, I told about Emacinae, which are specialized predators. They are also called as thread-legged bugs. Often they resemble stick insects, which might be overlooked because of the unless you see their raptorial legs, they will be looking like exactly like a phasmid, that is stick insect. And mid-leg and hind legs are modified. These are the adaptive structures for this Emacinae, where they can crawl on the spider webs without getting entangled or trapped in the webs constructed by the spiders. And the forelegs are modified into raptorial ascent mantids, which are used to grab the prey, and they're predatory on almost all stages, including the eggs, juveniles, and adults of the spiders. These groups are very specialized for walking on the specialized legs for walking on the spider webs. And in case of Neuroptera, Mantispidae, and among Mantispidae also, that particular subfamily called Mantispinae is alone known to be an exact predator. And often they are not considered as predator because the host is not allowed to die. It lives even after the grubs of Mantispidae are turning into a pupa. The first insta larva is called as active planidia. In case of majority of the insects, they do not undergo hypermetamorphosis means. In case of hypermetamorphosis, the first insta larva is called as active planidia. Once the egg, the larva hatches out of the egg, it will be active in the first insta itself. But in case of other insects, the mother itself take care of that, because it will be laying the eggs on the host itself. But in case of Mantispidae, when you see the eggs are laid on the twigs or other environmental, it will be laying their eggs on plants, and the larva once hatches out, it will be traveling, it will be wandering around, and once the spider comes near to it, it will be getting itself attached to the. As you see in the first image, you'll be able to see the grubs of spider will be getting attached to the cephalothorax of the spider. And the female spider carries them to the nest where the eggs are being laid. The grubs of Mantispidae also feed on the hemolymph of the adult spiders. Foresy is being noticed. Foresy means the juveniles are being transported from one place to another by the adult spiders. And following are the major insect parasitoids belonging to the family Hymenoptera and Diptera. Among the Ichneumonidae, the particular subfamily called Pimplinae and Phygodunidae are alone considered as parasitoids of spiders. And even in Scleonidae, particular Sclionidae and Pteromelidae, they are also considered as ectaseroids of spiders, not on the other stages. They are particularly affecting the egg stages of the spiders. And in case of Diptera, it is Acroceridae, Sarcophaginae, and Tachinidae are acting as endoparasitoids of spiders. That is developing within internally in the spiders. For Hymenoptera and Ichneumonidae, as I told earlier, among the Pimplinae, this Polypstia groups is alone group gene, that is, as you know, Ichneumonidae is one of the largest family among the Hymenoptera. It consists of almost huge number of species present all over the world. So it will be, they will be grouping them based on the genus. And these two subfamilies are known to attack all, almost all stages of the spiders. They can develop internally of the eggs of spiders or as ectoparasitoids of adult spiders. They are also solitary and gregarious. That is, they can feed as a single larva can be feeding on a spider, or it can be a group of larva feeding on a egg mass or a adult spider. And following are the genera which are acting as parasitoids of eggs, and some of the genus which are acting as both ectoparasitoids and adult parasitoids. And some of the members in the subfamily called Cryptinae, they are predatory on, these are the exceptional cases where a parasitoid acting as a predator, predators of eggs. And this slide shows diversity of these ichneumonids and how the ichneumonid wasp uses its stinger or the ovipositor to inject the venom and paralyze the spider and lay their eggs. And some of the parasitoids, adult parasitoids, they do not even have wings. They are apterous and they can travel, they can move on the spider webs without getting entangled in the spider web, and it can lay their eggs on the spiders. And then the family called Sclionidae, which are exceptionally egg parasitoids, and they are also solitary. Only one parasitoid can develop within the egg of a spider. And some of the genera which are known to parasitize spiders are Idris Bays and Ceratobays are known to parasitize, of Sclionidae are known to parasitize spider eggs. And they are considered as idiobiont endoparasitoids, where they develop internally and there is no further development in case of spiders. They attack spiders belonging to Pholcidae and Theridiidae. The Pholcidae eggs are not covered using this silk of spiders, so which makes it more vulnerable to attack by these Sclionid parasitoids. And in case of bays also, they do not have wings. They try to crawl on the spider webs without getting entangled. Their legs are modified in that way. In case of Diptera, it is Acroceridae, small-headed flies. They are called as small-headed flies and spider flies. They are exclusively parasitic on spiders, that is adult spiders, not on other stages of spiders. They are parasitic on juvenile and adult stages of spiders. All this known, what does exclusively means? In case of Acroceridae, all the known species described so far till date are known to be parasitic on spiders, and they do not consume any other thing. I mean, as a grubs, the maggots of this Acroceridae, they do not feed on any other host. They depend on spiders completely, and their eyes are holoptic. Holoptic in the sense, the compound eyes are closer to each other, occupying the entire head. And adult flies of these groups are pollinators as other groups of flies, true flies. And the eggs are laid on the foliage or branches of the plants. As like mantispidae larva, these groups are also the first instar larva or active planidia. And they have to wander to find the host. and then they once the host spider comes near them, they grab the prey and they start developing on they enter into the cephalothorax of the they enter into the abdomen of the spider and starts developing internally of the internally inside the spider. These are very rare groups, and they are easily overlooked because they develop internally. These groups develop internally in the spiders, and they also it also make these groups very vulnerable to attack by the other predators, which are predatory on spiders. And they can't see whether a parasitoid is developing within the spider. So once the predatory wasp like Pompilidae or Spicidae or Crabronidae, when they look a spider, they try to capture it, and they won't be aware of the parasitoid developing within these spiders, which makes them this Acroceridae very vulnerable to the attack by these groups. Once the spider is killed, ultimately the whole parasitoid which is developing inside the spider also gets killed. And around the world, there are 53 genera known from Acroceridae, and only single genus, that is Subcentaurus, is known from India. And Acrocera is a widely distributed genus, so it might be in India also. The diversity of the Acroceridae, these flies, this is Acroceridae is still to be studied. We really don't know how many species are known from India. And this is this slide shows the development of Acroceridae within the spiders. And when you see the first and that is image A and B, you won't be able to see whether the spider is having any parasitoid developing within. And the arrow showing the where the larva is penetrated into the adult spider, and it is developing within the abdomen of the spider. And once it is ready for pupation, only it gets out. In image numbers, in image C, where you will be able to see the adult spider. So from the adult spider, after feeding, this Acroceridae maggot has teared the abdomen of the coming out of the adult spider by tearing it, and then it before pupate. It doesn't come out of the adult unless it it's going to pupate. And some of these groups are known to diapause, that is they become dormant for a short period of time as a maggots. As immature stages, once they get into inside the spiders, they become dormant, and they can be inside the spiders for several months without being noticed itself. And once they turn into pupa, the life cycle is very short. Even the adults are short-lived. And other diptera natural enemies include this Bombylidae, Ephedridae, Phoridae. Here comes the convergence, where these groups of natural enemies, that is this Bombylidae, Ephedridae, Phoridae, Sarcophagidae, Tachinidae, and all, they can act as both parasitoids as well as predators of this exax. When they have enough host, they can survive as predator also. They can consume more number of spider eggs, so they can act both as a predator as well as a parasitoid. And the following slides show the chloroplid, that is gorax and pseudogorax, which develops on the egg sac of Amblygidae. And the Amblygidae egg is carrying, the female Amblygidae is carrying the pupa of Chloroplidae, that is that gorax, pupa of gorax, which fed on its own egg sacs. This is also one of the behavior for phorotic behavior, where the pupa is carried by the Amblygid spiders. And this slide shows the parasitic complex, which stages and all are attacked by the groups of natural enemies. That is, the eggs are attacked by the ichneumonads, where the adult spiders internally attacked by these Acroceridae. And single eggs are attacked by Scleonidae, that is solitary in nature. And then the eggs are also attacked by Pteromelidae and other groups of dipteran parasitoids like Phoridae, Chloroplidae. And some of the exceptional cases are exact prediction in ichneumonids. We all might be knowing ichneumonids as parasitoids, where they consume the host and they develop on a single host. In the process of development, it kills the host. This is one exceptional case. The members of Cryptinae, that is Lemion and Camara, the genus, both these genus are known to be egg predators, where they consume several eggs of spiders and the egg sac of spiders belonging to Arenidae and Selenopidae. The first image shows three of the larvae developing in the spider egg sacs. The spider egg sac must be containing more than 10 to 20 eggs. The entire egg sac has been consumed by these the grubs of Hymenopteran, ichneumonid parasitoids, where they are acting as predators and not as parasitoids. And this is intraglial predation of Chrysopidae on spiders, where the species of Malada, which is known as a predator of mealybugs, aphids, and red spider mites in tea ecosystem, they are known to, due to competition, they predate upon the egg sacs and spiderlings of spiders in the tea ecosystem. Usually this doesn't happen, where the Malada is known to feed only upon the soft-bodied insects, especially this hemipterans like mealybugs, aphids, and other groups of red spider mites on the tea. But due to competition, they also consume the spiders, that is egg sacs and spiderlings of this specific group of spiders. And then the infanticide is also observed in case of Ichneumonidae, where the species of Satipota, which is a solitary coenobiont ectoparasitoid of a species of spider, where the mother removes the previously laid eggs and other developing larvae of the same species, killing its own progeny. This is mainly due to the parasitoids are solitary, where not more than a single adult can emerge from one spider. So the mother avoids competition among its own young one, and for that purpose, she removes the eggs and other developing larvae before laying her eggs. She not only removes the grubs and the larvae and eggs of other groups of parasitoids which are developing on the spiders, but also her own egg and fully grown larvae are being removed before laying her eggs. This slide shows, the first image shows she's removing her own egg which were laid before, and then in the second image you can see clearly see the egg is being removed, and then the initial instar larva is being removed in the third image, and the fourth image you'll be able to see the fully grown larva of the same species of wasp is being removed. This is this phenomenon is called as infanticide, that is killing its own progeny, and this is to avoid the competition among the same species. Before laying the eggs, the mother kills her own progeny, and then she lays her eggs. One can refer into following references. For further reading, you can refer into some of these references. Thank you.
Yeah, there are few questions. I think Prashant will handle the questions, and any other questions can be you can use chat box, and questions can be asked. We'll deal with the questions now. Over to you, Prashant.
Yeah. Thank you. It was a wonderful session, Shankaraman. Thanks for that. We have few questions here. I will be reading that questions one by one.
Sure, Sapish.
Mudasir into asks, I have a doubt regarding the predatory nature of dipterans on spiders. Since most of the dipterans having sponging type mouth parts, how they feed predate the eggs of spider?
Parasitoid means the adult doesn't feed on the the adult doesn't feed on the spiders. In case of diptera, the maggots, that is immature stages of the dipterans, are parasitic on spiders, not as the adults like Acylidae, where the adult can act as a predator. It's not the case. It is acting as a parasitoid, where only the immature stage of the insect being acting as a parasitoid. The immature stage of the dipterans are acting as parasitoids, not the adults.
Okay, thank you. Yeah. Divya Uma asks, is there any family of spiders that are more vulnerable to parasitism than others?
As far as I read, some of the references cite Theridiidae to be the most vulnerable groups of parasitoids. Vulnerable groups of spiders being attacked by these parasitoids. It is Theridiidae. So many references are there in case of Theridiidae, which are being attacked by both these groups of parasitoids, like Hymenoptera, whatever families I have mentioned, and also by dipteran parasitoids. I think Theridiidae will be the most vulnerable families. And there are several records for all. There are so many studies being conducted in that group. And in case of these studies in Indian sub-region is very rare. And whenever, if you're able to get such studies, it will be like a lottery or jackpot. Whenever you see a spider along with these groups of parasitoids, it's going to be definitely a new species.
Yes. Thank you. Harshit JV asks, Limayon species is in India. We usually think it is Gotra species.
Limayon is there in India. Actually, there are few species of Limayon in India where they are acting as egg predators. As parasitoids, as egg predators, where they can consume more than one egg. They can consume more than one egg, and they are acting as a... It belongs to subfamily called Cryptinae, where it can consume entire egg sac of a spider, and it pupates within the egg sac itself, where the adult emerges out.
Okay. Thank you. Thomas asks, can you please share example where the host spider have developed a defense mechanism to avoid parasites?
For this one, I have to refer because I have not seen any defense mechanism in case of parasitoids. There are only a few examples where insect has developed such defense mechanism. There are very few examples in case of insects itself. I really don't know about spiders. I have to refer regarding this.
Okay.
There are very few examples because there might be a lot of examples in case of insect groups developing resistance against a chemical insecticide or like that. But in case of defense mechanism against a live agent, that is avoiding a parasitoid or a predator, it is they are very little. We really don't know.
The study should happen or... citizen scientists should upload their observation about these things. Ranjit AP asks, can you please tell host manipulation in spider induced by ichneumonia?
I have no idea, sir. I will refer and let him know.
Okay. No problem. Divya Uma again asks, producing large number of eggs is one strategy probably.
Producing large number of eggs is in case of spiders or in case of parasitoids?
About spiders she's telling.
For spiders, okay. if it is in case of parasitoid, a particular species of parasitoid is not going to attack the entire batch of eggs of the spiders. It is most probably they are going to be a solitary where they will be developing inside a single egg. And the entire egg batch of the spider is not going to be affected when it is going to be affected by a parasitoid. But that's not the case in predators. Even if the adult spider has laid 20 number of eggs in a single batch, and when there is a predator which is going to attack that egg sac, the entire egg batch will be going. The entire egg batch will be consumed by the particular predator, and not even a single spider is going to see the next generation.
I have a doubt whether the venom used by wasp is the same as it uses for paralyzing the spiders. I mean, if it stings us, whether that is the same venom that paralyzes spider, or it's having different content like that.
In case of Pompilidae, it uses the same. When you capture a pompilids using your bare hand, it's going to inject the same venom which it is using for killing a spider. Are you able to understand?
Yeah. Yes.
In case of Achillea hymenoptera, that is the stinging wasp like Pompilidae or Speciidae or Crabronidae, which will give you, which will sting you when you capture it with your bare hands. It's going to sting you, and the same toxin it will be using to paralyze the spiders also.
Okay.
But that's not the case with these parasitoids like Ichneumonidae, where only nocturnal groups of Ichneumonids are known to sting, and they are not under Achillea, where they do not sting human being for injecting the venom. They'll be using those.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hello,
I think.
One more question from Chandu Bandi. Can you share details about the parasitoid wasp that manipulates the behavior of spider that makes spider spins different type of web? Which wasp do that?
I saw one example for this. I'll let him know. There is one species of parasitoid in family Ichneumonidae where it turns the spider into a zombie. It manipulates the behavior of the spider where it allows to construct its different type of web. And in that web, the parasitoid can pupate. After consuming the entire spider, it has to pupate somewhere, right? This parasitoid wasp, it has to undergo pupation somewhere.
Yes.
And in one species of Ichneumonidae, I don't remember the name of that species, but in case of one species of Ichneumonidae, such manipulation of host is being seen, observed in that case of Ichneumonid, where it turns the spider into a zombie, and it makes the host spider to construct a different type of web where the parasitoid after the larva of the parasitoid, after consuming the entire internal content of the spider, it pupates in that web.
Okay, thank you. And I think that was the last question for the day.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Over to Abhijit, sir.
Yeah. Thank you, Shankar Raman, for an excellent session. Really, it was a total new world for many, including me. Almost in nature, what and all happen, we can't imagine. It's like some crime movies or something like that. What we imagine, already nature has it. And all those things you have put in a single platform. And it was an excellent session. And all hope all have enjoyed it. And really thought-provoking. And we have through citizen science also, we can definitely contribute for many entomologists, and we can definitely give our valuable observation. So thank you very much. I thank you for all the participants here, and this was the 17th session, And probably from next week, we don't know. Probably we may do next week, and we'll be taking a break for some 3 months. And later we may start our webinar series again. So previous webinar sessions are available in our YouTube channel. Anyone who are interested can definitely view that and subscribe to our channel. So thank you very much once again. And thank you all on behalf of Team Saliga. And thanks especially to Shankar Raman for the wonderful session today. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you for inviting me, sir. And do forgive me if I have not made anything clear. And please feel free to send me a message through WhatsApp or Facebook. I'm always open for discussions regarding insects. Even I'm novice in case of spiders, where the people and audience over here might be having more knowledge. In case of spiders, and even in case of insects, I have quite little knowledge. And the audience over here might be having, I'm always open for discussion. Maybe sharing information is always good.
Thank you. Thanks a lot, Shankaraman. So nice of you. Yeah. So I think we will wind up the session. Thank you once again.
Thank you, sir.